Class 5 IMO Level 2. Mathematics question number 31. If 14 tenths 25 hundredths is subtracted from the product of 4.42 and 6, the resultant number obtained is 14 tenths and 25 hundredths is equal to 1.65. And the product of 4.42 and 6 subtracted by 1.65 is equal to 24.87. So the answer is A. Mathematics question number 32. How much greater is the smallest 5-digit number with all digits different and the largest 4-digit number with all different digits? The smallest 5-digit number with all different digits is 10,234. And the largest 4-digit number with all different digits is equal to 9,876. The smallest 5-digit number is 358 greater than the largest 4-digit number. Mathematics question number 33. Ramya started studying at the time shown below. After 2 hours 15 minutes, she took a stop and took some rest. She then studied for another 1 hour 45 minutes and then stopped at the time shown. How long was her rest period? So total time she studied is equal to 2 hours 15 minutes plus 1 hour 45 minutes, which is equal to 4 hours. From the clock, the total time she studied together with the resting time is equal to 9:20 minus 4:25, which is equal to 4 hours 55 minutes. In order to find out how much time she took rest, we have to subtract the total time she studied and the clock with the resting time, which is equal to 4:55 minus 4, which is equal to 55 minutes. She rested for 55 minutes. Mathematics question number 34. Find the perimeter of the given figure, not drawn to scale. We know opposite sides are equal in a rectangle. Breadth is 30 cm, so the opposite side is also 30 cm. Length, if we calculate, it is 29 cm, so the opposite side is also 29 cm. The remaining part, what we can add to find the perimeter is 6 cm, 3 cm, 9 cm, 12 cm, 4 cm, and 4 cm. So the perimeter of the given figure is equal to 156 cm. Mathematics question number 35. Which of the following figures are symmetrical? The figures 1 and 5 are only symmetrical. Mathematics question number 36. Star is twice the difference between the 6th and 10th multiple of 7. Find star. The 6th multiple of 7 is 42 and the 10th multiple of 7 is equal to 70. And the difference between these two is equal to 28. Since they have said that the star is twice the difference, so 28 into 2, which is equal to 56. So the star is 56. Mathematics question number 37. Niharika has 9,600 rupees. She spends 1 by 3 of her money on clothes and 1 by 2 of the remaining money on food. How much money is left with her? So, amount she spent for clothes is equal to 9,600 into 1 by 3, which is equal to 3,200. And the remaining she spent for food. So, in order to find the remaining, we have to subtract the total from how much she spent the clothes. 9,600 minus 3,200 into 1 by 2 is equal to 3,200. So total money she spent is equal to 3,200 plus another 3,200, which is equal to 6,400. In order to find how much money is left with her, we have to subtract the money she spent, which is equal to 3,200. Mathematics question number 38. The given graph shows the career chosen by students of a class. The total students in the class is 300. Study the graph carefully and answer the following questions. How many chooses lawyer as the career? In order to find how many lawyers are there, we have to subtract the teacher, dentist, nurse, and doctor from the total students in the class. That is equal to 28 students. So 28 students chose lawyer. Mathematics question number 39. The given table shows the weight of 5 friends. If the total weight of all the 5 students is 289 kg, 500 gram, then find the weight of Aman. In order to find the weight of Aman, we have to add Kavya, Kamal, Karan and Anshal and then subtract it from the total weight, which is equal to 62 kg. So Aman is 62 kg. Mathematics question number 40. 3 containers P, Q, R contain 425 liters of water altogether. Container P contains thrice as much water as container Q. Container R contains 19 liters more than the container P. How much quantity of water is there in container R? Given, PQR can hold 425 liters of water. Let us take it as the equation 1. Given, P can contain 3 times of Q. So we will take that as equation 2. As Q is equal to P divided by 3. Next, they have given R contains 19 liter more than P. So we can take it as equation 3. As R is equal to P plus 19 liter. Substituting equation 2 and 3 in equation 1, we can get the value of P, which is equal to 174. Now, substitute the value of P in equation 3 to get the value of R, which is equal to 193 liters. So, the value of R is equal to 193 liters. Mathematics question number 41. Tanya has 7.8 meters of thread. If she needs 3 meter thread to make a necklace, then how many necklaces can she make and how much thread is left with her? Length of thread needed to make one necklace is equal to 3 meter. So in order to find how many necklaces she can make, we have to divide it. 7.8 divided by 3, which is equal to 2 necklaces, and remaining is 1.8 meter. Mathematics question number 42. 520 gram of tiny pink pebbles are mixed with 580 gram of tiny purple pebbles. We hand pack the mixture of tiny pebbles into 5 equal packets. How many grams of mixture are there in each packet? We have to first find the total of pink and purple pebbles, which is equal to 1100. In order to find how much grams are there in each packet, we have to divide it by 5. If we divide, we'll get 220. So there are 220 grams in each packet. Mathematics question number 43. The table shows the cost of cashews, all stalls X, Y, and Z. Which of the following stalls sell the cashews at the same price? Let us find 1 kg price for stall Y and stall C. 650 gram of cashew price in Y stall is 117. Therefore, 1000 grams of cashews in stall Y is equal to 117 into 1000 divided by 650, 180 rupees. Similarly, 1000 cashews in Z stall, which is equal to 162 into 1000 by 900, which is equal to 180 rupees. So, all the stalls have the same price for the cashews. Mathematics question number 44. Atul had 2000 rupees. He bought potatoes for 115.40 paise, rice for 310 rupees 50 paise, sugar for 549 rupees 45 paise, and fruits for 498 rupees 99 paise. How much money is left with him? First, we have to add all the expenses and then we have to subtract it from the total money, which is equal to 525.66 paise. Mathematics question number 45. Find the HCF and LCM of 42, 63 and 105. Let us find HCF of these numbers by the division method. So the HCF of these numbers using division method is equal to 21. Let us do the same with LCM and we'll use the same division method. So LCM of these numbers is equal to 630. That is the C option. That's it for this video. Make sure to subscribe. hit that like button, turn on post notifications so that you guys never miss out on a video that I upload. And I'll see y'all next time. Goodbye.